See, IT is surely, like, if you see Mahindra Finance, majority of the business is more dependent on IT because of the rural infrastructure. And we do have that issues like connectivity, electricity and reaching is a big thing. And Mahindra Finance slogan is reach and speed. How fast we can reach to the customer and how fast we can do it. And Mahindra Finance is very clear to say, like, in rural industry, people should think, if they are in demand of money, they should think about Mahindra Finance. So can that M&M can work using mobile technology? That's what we call some 3M, which is nothing but money, Mahindra Finance and mobile. So it enables and it can make it out of that. And surely we believe in that mobile is going to do some very big miracle in the rural industry. And surely we can ensure that reach and speed. And Mahindra Finance, if you see last 3-4 years, majority of the business rooted in terms of collection, everything is through mobile. So we believe in the technology is going to do further more on that. Say digital inclusion, financial inclusion, this all comes part of the compliance and regulatory from RBI, CIBIL, CRISIL, all these things. Keeping in mind, earlier we thought, like, can we just embrace to just technology to it out, but we found no, it required some different attention. We created some vendors who are from a local side where they are able to help us in doing financial inclusion, digital inclusion, where we are able to take photographs, we are able to take biometrics, we are able to take voice record of the customers. Already we have gone into the stage to say, like, how we can still fix it out to say, like, for customer photograph, whether it's really taken or a photograph taken on photograph. So such kind of demand is made, and surely technology is going to have a differentiator there. And we do all our audits, majority of the things through technology, YouTube, and we are able to record the conversation between the dealer and the customer, dealer and the other brokers, sub-agents, then customers, end customers, my executive versus our customers. So these are the combinations which we are able to extract it. Earlier it was a big, nightmare where whether these are things possible. But surely it's happening on the some pocket. I won't say innovation, it is demand. Like, no, you have to survive, you have to do that. So you have to go by the best whatever is available. That's why if you see the pioneers in some areas like mobility, all those things, we do have the problems. But I will say the other area, like, at least that 100% has come to now 40%. So we are having only 20% issues. At least 80% we are succeeding and going down. And innovation is playing a major role. Otherwise, we are not able to go through that much scale. And innovation is an area where what we feel is what if demand is there, and demand versus the actual, whatever it is, which we can use our pain points, which we are able to reduce that pain. Surely that innovation is value. And it's converted in terms of value for customers and value for business, which yields the liquidity. If you take in finance industry, how fast the money moves from a financier to the customer, customer to the financier, that's a game. If we are able to do it and faster process using the available technology, that's a success for us. And we will go to that much extent which gives within the regulation compliance and how fast we can do so that a customer feels that a customer delight. Same way the management also gets the liquidity of funds, so no need to borrow from outside so that we can refund, reuse the funds which is available on time. Yes, surely. From beginning, at least we do have some dreams. Like, you know, it's all our past dreams, how to do it. So we know that kind of scalability. That's why we don't have any urban spoke. We kept something called centralized storage with distributed data capture, so that across the country, you put even 1 rupee, it comes to central site only. So now we have created a DRS. We are already working on it. We have strengthened as much as the central site so that across the country, people can use only bank using any of the channels like e-pass device, mobile device, you call it kiosk, you call it any device, computer, broker device, like anything from broker is subjected to that latest available technologies. That particular information is connected to central site and we are able to achieve it. So surely the part in terms of availability of technology is going to have a differentiation. But the risk is what we keep adopting to the new technology, so we have to build that constant innovative products which is available in the market and affordable products which we can take it up. Since the community is going to be rural and our operations is going to be rural, so we have to make something local to Indianness. So these are the applicable chances for us to do it. But surely the model which we have framed from beginning is helping us to do a lot. So that centralized system, so no need to much do anything on that. If I want to set something for my 7000 device, I'll do it in one part in head office. I'm able to distribute everything through technology. So which was very difficult in good olden days, for even 600 locations, it takes 30 days. Today we are able to do it within 3 hours. So technology has surely enabled, and the architect, whatever I said, centralized storage, distributed data capture, keeping a single data storage, and it's enabling us to do for the SAN part, whichever is on the application side. Again, NAS part, whatever you call it, file and print, communication, customer, end user, educate that information, end user communication details, mails, because these all things comes very critical when any frauds happening in the last mile. And people tend to do the supporting, how it has empowered, what kind of monitoring mechanisms we have to do it out. And CRISIL CIBIL is very keen on such communications, how we do it for the end customer. So those all the things are available in the central side. So nobody can tamper it or nobody can tick with that. And advantages what? Like, since it's kept in one place, we are able to push it, pull it the way we want it, and available devices here. So we would say like these are the dreams which you have fetched it, and unfortunately the things are not going the wrong way. So fortunately everything is set the way it is, and the right way, right things, right partners has enabled us to do it. Currently we are doing, in terms of if you see even our architecture, Mahindra Finance, very few people know it's only finance, it's not finance, it is into so many subsidiaries like Mahindra Insurance Broking Limited, Mahindra Rural Housing, Mahindra Gold Loans, Mahindra Personal Loans, these are the subsidiaries under Mahindra Finance umbrella. Already we are doing a cloud computing sharing for all those people, already we are doing a virtualization for all those people, so they all run on our backbone infrastructure, they are all sharing on our own infrastructure, keeping the regulation apart from the customer information, all those things, they are able to share the infrastructure, they are able to share the available technology deployed for Mahindra Finance as a group to one. So already we are doing it to in-house from 2007. So, but if you say again now, are you interested in co-locating to something else? Surely in India, within the RBI regulations, whatever it is, surely we would like to do that. And we are able to convert that data into critical and non-critical. Out of that, again, we are able to plot out something called service, something called controls. So controls and compliance, we said, we'll continue to have it private cloud, which will be within part of Mahindra. But surely the service part in terms of task force, talking to them, task force getting the communication, or customer would want to do that. All those things we are already into getting it to a private cloud, provided by the data we would want to keep it in India. We don't want to keep outside. But surely we are already going for co-hosting. And for my microfinance, already we are doing some outsource where the data server, everything is co-located on there. Since the transaction value is very less, so we thought we will do from an outsource model so that the product will get the benefits. If that regulation part works out fine, the same can be replicated to other things. See, every year we generally come out with 14 to 15 projects because we do have some aligned projects which is for the business. And this year, like if you take in specific, we have three different major issues going on where we said like we will try to get customer aligned with the mobile solutions. Then the inclusion, the data, whatever which is coming out now, can we get more secured and can we build, like we've made some concept called data matters. If you remove D, it's ATA matters, no? So you have to be very clear in discipline. So the D stands for discipline and ensure the discipline so that the data matters for us. So that project we are carrying out. The third one is what, like we have created something bigger where Mahindra Finance first time come out with a big concept called Mahindra Finance 2.1.2. Where Mahindra Finance South and East together and Mahindra Finance North and West together, whatever they have done last year, now they have to do two different volumes as a different two different companies, keeping IT and other support functions same, and they have improved that, increased the business size for this financial year. So keeping such kind of targets, so we said like we will use as much as technology partners, as much as which can make more automation through technology so that the manual process is not required. So from IT side, we said we will continue with the existing resource. We will continue with the existing available resource available. We said we will ensure this task completed this year, and that task is pushed to the IT team now, including business increase, including the business support increase, including the collection last year and this year going to increase, and the other part is on the solution part, like whether customer wants any customer solutions, customer looking for some service in specific on it. So all those things now, this time IT has committed, where we can use the available resource without not adding a single penny to that, they are going to deliver it. So this is the first time we have taken the risk, keeping the centralized storage which will empower as much as volume. So in a nutshell, if you say like if last month, last year expected 40,000 business a month, this year it's going to be 80,000 to 1 lakh. So same infrastructure is going to support 1 lakh. So that's the confidence we said, look, no, surely it will support that company 2, company 1 with the same volume. So that's a commitment for the existing, which we said again the partners has planned properly and helped us to do such great things.